In this video, I bring you 5 things you can do to remember your patterns for West Coast Swing. What's up, gang? Brian B here from westcoastswingonline.com on our Frustration Friday video series, where every Friday we upload a helpful video for a frustrating, difficult part of West Coast Swing. So this is the number two frustration that I hear from new dancers. Number one is staying on time. There's a video on that. But we're talking about remembering our patterns. So I'm gonna give you 5 tips to remember your patterns. So number one, and this is the one that I think we all get, and that is to either write down notes or take a video. So most of us have a video camera, otherwise known as an iPhone, in our pocket, and we will video and take notes. That is step one. And I know that some of you engineers, we've got some students right here in the studio that have big notebooks with all lessons from their notes. That's great, but most of us stop there. The number two most important thing of our list of 5 is to practice. Okay, yeah, Brian, we have to practice. But a lot of us, let's say, have a lesson here in Dance Louisville. It's Thursday night, but then people might not dance again until next Thursday. Way too long. Now, we had a coach, Miss Megan and I were talking about what our coach reminded us, something to the effect of, after 24 hours, you've lost 50 to 70% of the information, and after 48 hours, you're like 90% gone. So you need to practice often. My suggestion, we're all normal people. We have regular lives and jobs and things that we have to do outside of dancing. But my recommendation is, after a lesson, take 5 or 10 minutes to practice, or take 5 or 10 minutes before your lesson, either your private lesson or group class, to practice. So take that video, write a note. Number two, you are gonna practice very quickly after. Here in our class, I would recommend someone after class run everything for 5 or 10 minutes right afterwards to click it in your brain. Boom, off you go. Number three, because now you've left the studio and you're driving around the car, visualize. And there's lots of interesting data about people who have broken an arm. They're competitive athletes. They break an arm. They're losing muscle strength in that arm. And they literally just imagine doing curls and exercises with their arm. And they're able to retain an amazing amount of strength. Sorry to interrupt, but if you like what you see, please take a second to subscribe to the YouTube channel. That's the red button in the bottom right of the screen. And when you're done watching the video, head over to westcoastswingonline.com, enter your email, and you'll be part of our exclusive Move of the Week club. Thanks, and we look forward to seeing you on the dance floor soon. I've even had students in here that have had routines, and they've been out for long periods of time and done nothing but mentally remember. So there is some really good science that says that visualization is very important. So even when you're away, driving the car, just try to run through a mental checklist of those patterns. Even think high-level athletes, they are visualizing being in the Olympics and their performances. So that's number three, is to visualize. You don't have to be on a dance floor to do that. Just takes a little bit of mental effort. Number four is to understand your patterns, the base pattern. So let's say you've come and learned a complicated pattern and you're trying to sort it out in your brain and visualize it. Underneath that crazy pattern is one of 3 basics typically. It's gonna be some sort of a sugar push or push break. It's some sort of a side pass, a right or left side pass, also called an underarm turn, or some sort of whip. So if you can start to understand your patterns, base pattern, it'll be easier. So I learned a move here in class and it was based off a whip, but it was a reverse whip with an outside turn, let's say, right? So you wanna kind of create a tree of branches of patterns, but understanding which base pattern your pattern comes from will go a long way. And then number 5, and this is a secret that all of us teachers know, you will learn more from teaching than you actually do as the student. Because as a teacher, I have to know it and articulate it back, and it kind of grooves those neural pathways a little bit better. So if you could teach, and I'm not recommending that you correct people in group class, but if you could even explain it to people around you, explain it to a friend, to your dance partner, just if you could show it or verbally communicate it, that's also very helpful. The people around me know I do that all the time. When I learn a new topic, I talk about it constantly, and that's helping me remember. So your 5 tips, and if you forget these, there is a link in the corner or in the description below where we have a blog post with these 5 tips and some other resources that will help you. But number one, take notes. Number two, you wanna practice, practice soon. Number three, visualize. Number four, remember the base pattern in what you're trying to remember. And number 5, the more difficult one, is to teach it to someone else, or at least explain it so it will help remember your patterns. Awesome. So if you have not yet, please subscribe to the YouTube channel. That's the red button down there. Head over to westcoastswingonline.com, enter your email. You will be part of our Move of the Week Club. Plus, you will get 20 free videos on our site, and then we can communicate via video. That's how we come up with these topics, is we interact with tens of thousands of West Coast Swing dancers around the world to create great content for you guys. So thanks, and we will see you next week for Frustration Fridays here on YouTube.